this new record. I did a bunch of songs on it about a
Butch.
Big Butch.
Yeah.
Woo! So Big Butch. Being best friends with him. Woo! Which wasn't always the case. And some of you might have been through this too, where when you were 16 years old, trying to connect with your dad who was going through his own problems and his own midlife crisis and losing his own parents at that time. I mean, shit, he was actually my age now, which is really crazy to think about. But I'm gonna tell you a funny story about my dad. He was this pretty gruff, you know, hard-nosed, hard-living, blue-collar, hard-working individual from a town called Tater Hill, Georgia. And that's not potato. They actually spelled it tater. I can't make this shit up. So, you know, here his son, 16 years old, actually, not even 16, I realized I wanted at 8 years old to play music when he made the mistake of me begging him and him actually seceding and taking me to see Kiss in 1977. Stop me if I've told you this before. I've told you this before. I know, I wrote a book, fuck. Anyway. Yeah, he did. All right, this is my story, shut the fuck up. Anyway, I won't tell that part. But my dad had a bad taste in his mouth after that concert. I'll just put it that way. And so at 16, I'm sitting here, you know, wanting to be in a rock band. I'm growing my hair long. I'm wearing my sister's clothes. Wearing my sister's makeup. Wearing my sister's earrings. And this guy is just looking at me like, so I get it, you know, I totally get it. He didn't understand it. He came from a small town. He didn't know anything about rock music and what it was doing to my soul. And you know, he just kind of grinned and bared. And he put my two older sisters through college, which they didn't have, you know, we didn't have any money. He didn't have a pot to piss in, and he just took all of his money that he made from his job and put them through college. And I think he expected to try to do the same for me. And I said, I'm not going to go to college. I said, I'll save you the money, Dad. I said, I'm going to go to Los Angeles, and I'm gonna get a record deal for my band. And he's just like, but, you know, I did. I went out there, and 10 months later, my band was signed to this, you know, big recording contract, and I finally had my own money, and he'd never given me a dime anyway. I had to support myself with a day job and all that, and so I came back and I said, Dad, I'm making my own living now, check this out, you know, and I think that was the one thing he was worried about, is that it would be a better chance of getting struck by lightning than actually making a fucking dollar making music. And that's the first time I saw him laugh and cry at the same time. From that point forward, my dad became my best friend and my biggest fan and the big brother I never had. And he stayed that way for the next 20, 25 years, I guess. Because, you know, cut to him. Here's the thing. See, my dad, then he got a bug up his ass. He wanted to retire his job at AT&T after 30 years and go on the road selling merch for me. Now this is back when it was lean times, where we would play anywhere for $100 and play to like the bartender, you know, and he didn't care. He just took it as a chance where he could probably talk to some girls, and he did. And I just know that the best times I have and the best memories I have during those times, that was back in the 90s, I think it was. And we we'd sit there on those hotel floors, just a shitty hotel in the middle of nowhere, getting hammered drunk after a show and passing out on one another on the floor. And I was like, man, if anybody knew my dad turned out this cool. And he did. And so he never missed a show after that, every time I came back and played through Atlanta. And until about 2 months ago. He even made me bring him a copy of this new record, because he's got to be the first to hear everything. So I sat there and I held his hand and I played him this song. And I said, Dad, this one's about you. And he just smiled and he said, I love it, that's nice. Say goodbye for good. I make all my best decisions for the day that lies ahead of me in the morning. I make all the worst decisions even when the poison hits my mind. Through hell and just pray he turns out half the man he was.